Where can I download Windows 11, or 10, or 8? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's not uncommon to want to download a fresh copy of Windows, and unlike many years past, there are now legal ways to do exactly that. I'm going to show you, basically, where you can get those downloads. First, I want to point you at the article associated with this video. It's askleo.com/5052, or as you can see in the address bar here, askleo.com/download-windows. This article contains the links I'm about to tell you, and is probably the easiest way to figure out where to go for the various versions of Windows. When I need to download Windows, I go to my own article so that I can find the links. So, first of all, I am going to throw out a huge caveat, and that caveat is simply this. There are legal places to download it from, and there are not legal places to download it from. I'm focusing only on the ones that I know to be legal, which basically boils down to Microsoft itself. Anywhere else, you run the risk of not just being illegal, but getting something more than you bargained for in the form of malware included with whatever it is you're downloading. So my suggestion is that you focus only on the downloads available from Microsoft directly. So let's do it in reverse order. You can download Windows 11. I'm going to click on that and show you what it looks like. You have the option to run the installation assistant or to create installation media. Usually, that's the one you want, installation media, if you're asking how to do this. This will allow you to create an ISO that you can burn to a DVD or a bootable USB that you can then use as your installation media. For Windows 10, you'll end up with either an update or to be able to create Windows 10 installation media. Same idea. You'll get either an ISO or a media creation tool that will let you then create a USB bootable Windows 10 installation disk. Now, Windows 8.1, which is honestly surprising that it's still available, is still available. The difference here is that the only option you have here is to download an ISO of the image. So we've selected the version of Windows, we've selected the language. At this point, I believe it'll actually start downloading a very large ISO for Windows 8.1. That one you'll need to either burn to a bootable DVD or use another tool, I think Rufus will do the work, to actually get that ISO onto a bootable USB. But those are the right places to get a download of those versions of Windows. Now, like I said, it's going to be big. Each of these is measured in gigabytes. I'm not even sure if for Windows 11, I think you actually need a 16 gigabyte USB stick if you're going to go that route. It may be much less than that, but I think an 8 gigabyte USB stick isn't going to be enough. Windows 10, Windows 8, smaller by some amount. Now, what happens if you install one of these versions of Windows and your product key doesn't work? Well, first, with Windows 10 and Windows 11, they've switched to what's called digital licensing, which means that if Windows 10 or Windows 11 had been previously installed on that hardware, you shouldn't need a license key. It should just install and activate automatically, which is great. I actually like the whole digital license key. As long as you've got the same machine, you can reinstall and install that version of the operating system essentially as many times as you like. If you still are sitting with a situation where Windows won't activate because you don't have a valid license key, then, well, you're kind of sort of stuck. There's really only two approaches to this. One is to, well, you can live with it. You'll be running restricted. In other words, there are some features of Windows that won't be enabled. Most importantly, perhaps, Windows Update. But I've seen people running this way for a variety of reasons. And honestly, yeah, that's okay if it does enough for you. The other solution is to purchase a legitimate license key. And I specifically want to focus on legitimate because many of the discount license keys that are available online, they're not legitimate. You run the risk of them working for a while, not working at all, or somehow not working quite right. Typically because they are OEM license keys not intended for generic machines. If you're in a situation where you have an OEM machine, a Dell or any of the brand name machines, certainly one of the things you should do is check with them for either your original license key, if they have it, or downloadable media from them so that you get the appropriate custom drivers and other information for your specific machine. But even if you use the downloads that I've shown you here, which are generic retail downloads, you can still typically get those machine-specific drivers and add-ons by then after installing Windows, going to their site and downloading and installing those separately. But that's how it is. Now, you can, of course, download and install Windows with a purchase directly from Microsoft. In fact, if I click on that here, you'll see that it comes to the Microsoft Online Store, which basically allows you to purchase the software. That's another option if you don't have a working license key and you want to purchase and move on to Windows 11. They're no longer selling you Windows 10, so that's not an option here. But Windows 11, absolutely. But those are your options. And I think it's very, very handy and important to understand that those downloads for Windows 8.1, 10, and 11 are indeed available. And like I said, my reference place for those links is my own article, where you'll find updates, comments, related links, and more at askleo.com/5052. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.